Please be seated. Inga mana, inga reo, inga hoe fa. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Pro-Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, University staff, special guests, graduands, whānau and supporters. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of the Council members and staff of the University. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland at which the Pro-Chancellor and I will confer diplomas and award degrees in the Faculty of Arts. Graduation is a time for celebrating success. Today, you will experience the pomp and tradition of this ancient ceremony and the recognition befitting your success on your well-deserved day of celebration. Like your family and friends gathered here, we are very proud of all your achievements and look forward to your lifelong involvement as members of the University of Auckland family. Of course, graduation represents much more than just a day of celebration. Your qualification from this university will have a lifetime impact on you, your family, and the community at large. We know that, compared to those whose formal education ends in high school, graduates have lower unemployment rates, higher salaries, better career prospects, and better health outcomes. Universities New Zealand has estimated the lifetime benefits of earning a degree are valued at between $1 million and $4 million. So your university experience and the qualifications gained at university will thus add real value to your lives and to the lives of those around you. The fact that our university can add value in these ways reflects the abilities and achievements of our staff and students. In the Faculty of Arts, we've seen several notable achievements in the last year. For example, Professor Margaret Mutu won the Royal Society of New Zealand Po Aranui Award for her contribution to Indigenous rights and scholarship in New Zealand. Distinguished Professor Damian Salmond was elected an international member of the American Philosophical Society for her scholarship in anthropology and Māori studies. And Dr. Jake Mahaffey's film Free Indeed won the Orazzini Award for Best Film at the 72nd Venice International Film Festival. And Dillis Johns was elected a fellow of the International Institute for Conservation of Historic and Artistic Works in London. In order to ensure that we can continue to achieve successes like these and to enhance our contribution to future generations of graduates and our nation, the university must do three things, in my opinion. First, we need to attract students of high academic potential and give them an outstanding academic and extracurricular experience. In this respect, we're doing very well. The proportion of domestic students entering the university with a high grade point average is growing each year and we produce outstanding graduates, just like you. Second, we need to attract, develop, and retain outstanding staff. This we are doing, as illustrated by the achievements I've described earlier. Many of our staff are world leaders in their fields, and you have been privileged to learn from and work with them. So it's no convenience that, in the QS World Rankings of University Subjects, the University of Auckland came top in New Zealand in 35 of the 40 ranked subjects. We don't even teach two of them. So out of the 38 subjects which are ranked, we are top in 35. I think that's a pretty good result. And third, we need to create the kind of academic environment and facilities that support and encourage excellence. To this end, the university has been investing heavily in its campus renewal program so as to ensure that we do provide facilities of genuinely international quality. Many of you will graduate today with a first qualification, and you will be rightly proud of this achievement. However, I also want you to reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at this university. You must never rest on your laurels in a challenging and ever-changing world, but rather be prepared to embrace change and new technology and make the most of the opportunities presented to you. Although it may seem a daunting prospect right now, further study and learning is inevitable for us all as the world changes around us at an ever-accelerating pace. So whatever path you follow, I urge you as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university to never forget your alma mater, your university. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. But today is your day, with the focus firmly on your achievement. At this ceremony, we honour your success, along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you all and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. I'm very pleased to extend a warm welcome to Kirsty Trail, who is the first speaker in this year's autumn graduation ceremonies and an alumna of this university. She holds a bachelor's degree in arts and commerce with Japanese and marketing as her specialities. Kirsty is the vice president of customer support at Hootsuite, the world's most widely used social media relationship platform, where she is responsible for using customer insights to drive strategic initiatives and deliver a superior customer experience. The company is one of Fortune magazine's fabled unicorns, companies with a valuation of more than $1 billion. Kirsty was previously the chief customer advocate at Snapfish, a San Francisco-based online photo merchandising company. She has more than 14 years international experience gained from senior sales and marketing operations and business management roles in the United States, Canada, Japan, and New Zealand, where she has a track record of effective leadership and business transformation. Kirsty has been a long-term board member at Tandem Bay Area, an organization focused on early childhood literacy. She enjoys snowboarding, hiking, and traveling, and she is a certified rescue diver and yoga instructor. Would you please join with me in welcoming Kirsty?
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of Council, members of the university, graduands, families, whānau, and friends. My name is Kirsty Trail, and I graduated from the University of Auckland with an arts degree in Japanese and a commerce degree in marketing in 1997. Since graduating university, I have enjoyed a long career in the technology sector, which has taken me to Tokyo, Vancouver, and San Francisco to live, and allows me to travel the world all in the name of work. Today I'm here to give you my advice on how to get the most out of your degree and maximise your chance of success. Now that you have completed your University of Auckland Arts degree, success really comes down to three key things: purpose, passion, and potential. Purpose. The Oxford English Dictionary defines purpose as the reason for which something is done or created, or for which something exists. Ask yourself, why do you think you are here? What are the key attributes or skills you have to offer? Or fundamentally, what makes you excited to get out of bed in the morning? Find your purpose and pursue it relentlessly. That is the key to happiness. A great piece of advice that was given to me upon my graduation some many years ago was to not look for the job in arts, but rather to seek out the arts in the job. In moving to Tokyo, I took up a marketing role for which I had to communicate in Japanese every day. It was here that I found the arts in my job and enjoyed a wonderful 3 years perfecting my Japanese language skills and making lifelong friends. Even today, in my role as VP of Customer Support at Hootsuite, a social media relationship platform, I find my arts degree helps me approach issues from a different perspective, particularly as the industry goes through a major digital disruption and the customer becomes king or queen. As an aside, New Zealanders are pretty cool people globally, admired for our work ethic, combined with our unique ability to remain humble and down to earth, as well as the aptitude to think differently from the norm. Embrace this and use it in your life and on your travels. Elizabeth Gilbert, author of Big Magic, sums up purpose very eloquently as, "Do whatever brings you to life. Follow your own fascinations, obsessions, and compulsions. Trust them. Create whatever causes a revolution in your heart." Which brings me to the second key to success: passion. Passion and purpose are deeply intertwined. If you are having trouble finding your purpose, figure out your passion, for that will lead you directly into your purpose. Passion is what drives you to keep going. It's that feeling in the pit of your stomach or the tingling in the base of your spine when you know you're just doing what you love. Following your curiosity is a great way to helping you find your passion. After all, this is what led Steve Jobs to a random typography class and thus developed his ideas in design. In doing so, he infused art into technology and revolutionized personal computing, music, and mobile communication. Speaking of Steve Jobs, he famously once said, "The only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking. Don't settle. As with all matters of the heart, you'll know when you find it." Another example is Elon Musk, CEO of Tesla Motors, the electric car manufacturer. Musk is relentlessly pursuing ways to make the world a better place. And if that doesn't work out, we can all rely on him to get us to Mars on SpaceX. Or William Shakespeare, widely regarded as the greatest writer in the English language. With 38 plays and 154 sonnets in a short 52-year life, it is very clear he was passionate about his work. Your arts degree has given you a good foundation in learning and shapes the way you see the world. Art inspires, regardless of who you are or where you come from. Your degree in arts will help you see the world through a different lens. Use and apply this, and never stop learning. As Friedrich Nietzsche, German philosopher, said, "Is life not 100 times too short for us to bore ourselves?" In doing so, I think he was giving us that permission to be the weirdo who loves what they do. It makes life a heck of a lot more enjoyable, I can assure you. It is also important to distinguish between following your passion and cultivating your passion. Following your passion implies that you discover your passion in advance and then go match it to a job, at which point you're done. Cultivating your passion implies that you work towards building passion. This is a longer process, but it's way more likely to pay dividends. It requires you to approach your work like a craftsman, honing your ability and then leveraging your value, once good, to shape your working life towards the type of lifestyle that resonates with you. As arts graduates, you likely already know something about passion. A degree in arts is not completed by those who are merely ambivalent about their course of study. In this world of career focus, undertaking an arts degree is a big step in, if not following your passion, then beginning to cultivate it. Just completing your degree is a major achievement in passion cultivation, and for this, I applaud you. Potential. When it comes to your potential, dream big. Graduating today, I hope that all of you possess the thinking that you can be anything you want to be. You are only limited by your own passion. Tune into your purpose, ignite your passion, and think really hard about where it could possibly take you. Dream a little. And then write it down. That may sound trite. However, a study by Gail Matthews, a psychology professor at the Dominican University in California, found that you are 42% more likely to achieve your goals if you write them down. Just to be clear, reaching your potential does not mean rising to the top or making the most money. It means looking very hard at how you personally define success and then finding your own path to get there. To do this, you need to possess a certain level of self-awareness. This means knowing what you are good at and where you need help. Understanding what stands between you and the next job, and by that I mean skills and not people, and really taking a critical look at what you need to get there, gives you the ability to start working on those skills even before the role is advertised or the job sometimes even exists. In today's technology-driven world, there are roles that will exist 10 years from now that we couldn't possibly imagine today. Dream big. Don't limit your potential and recognize opportunities when they come your way. Be open to the road less traveled. It may not be as popular, but it's a heck of a lot more interesting, and you're guaranteed to learn much more along the way. Without a doubt, it's what led me to where I am today. University of Auckland, Arts Graduands of 2016. These are your three key elements for success in life. Find your purpose. Pursue it relentlessly with passion. And never stop believing in your highest possible potential. Congratulations on your graduation. The end of your studies marks the start of an exciting world ahead. I wish you all the best on your journey.
Thank you, Kirsty, for a most insightful and challenging address. Can you all join with me in thanking Kirsty once again? This is a meeting of council in convocation of the university, at which the Pro-Chancellor, Scott St. John, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of the ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Scott St. John, Pro-Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who within the Faculty of Arts have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Arts, Professor Greenberg, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honor of presenting to you students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Arts. Graduate Diploma in Arts. Justine Leah Davies. Jin Yang Wanfu. Lawiti Iti Lamasina Oliana Maiai. Akura Temata Otahiti Makea Partington. Ruvia Rim. To the degree of Bachelor of Arts. Shalu Shazlin Ara. Iman Abu Laila. Briar Marie Hope Adams. Veronica Aguilera Morales. Sarah Tuifonualava Latoa Aho. Zuher Al-Shakif. Safa Muhammad Hussein Alewi. Bridget Mary Catherine Allen. Coralie Marie Allen. Dunya Gisi Alvalachi. Laura Holly Anderson. Lisa Stephanie Anderton. Samantha Hannah Andresen. Georgina Francis Anton. Nerissa Noel Appa. Yes. Rebecca Louise Armiger. Sarah Kiros Acefa. Senior Scholar in Arts, Gai Yi Stephanie Ao Jung. Rebecca Kate Alsford. Simon Thomas Baker. Claire Elizabeth Anna Baldwin. Melissa Ponpon Bangkok. Yangqi Bao. Isabella Teresia Barker. Mifanwi D. Barling. Suzanne Shannon Barlow. Sophie Elizabeth Barnett. Yasmin Kayla Barry. Morgan Beth Bartholomew. Charlotte Annalise Bass. Laura Elizabeth Bates. Jennifer Ann Beckham. Andrew John Bester. Niall Luis Ellery McCarthy Bijou. Monica Louise Elise Binney. Elizabeth Grace Blair. Oh, I'm sorry, Blair Finley. Sorry about that. Catherine Faith Jarina Blenkinsop. Madeline Grace Bloxham. Daniel Sidney Bonner. Matthew Brian Boniface. Jacqueline Dominique Canseco Bocquiron. Larissa Kate Bottomley. Jessica Savannah Narsarian Burke. Rayleigh Joy Bradfield. Andrew William Brady Clark. Oh, these. Andrew William Brady Clark. Bertie Brandt. Lauren Jane Brentnell. Tina Brooke. Sean Kevin Brookman. Justine Ann Brown. Medina Melissa Hazel Brown. Shay Lorraine Burgess. Hannah Carol Burgoyne. Kate Louise Butler. Zhi Tsong Tsai. Rebecca Rose Cakebread. Claudia Josephine Borham Case. Abigail Colette Cowood. Ximin Tan. Sanjoli Chaitanya. Michelle Miriam Chamberlain. Lydia Alice Berry Chamley. Cheng Yen Chen. Devneel Pravitesh Chand. Navneet Ravikesh Chand. Charlene Jocelyn Chand. Harry Roy Chapman. Anusha Gopal Rao Chebi. Jixin Chen. Soo-hyun Cho. Eunsem Choi. Michael Choi. Yeso Choi. Eugene Choi. Joey Chong. Senior Scholar in Art, Sarah Jean Christensen. Catherine Suki Chung. Casey Julie Clark. Senior Scholar in Arts, David Reese Cole. Jordan Robert Coe. Demi Renata Cox. Angus George Craig. Gemma Crawford Liu. Floyd Wayne Cribb. Astrid Johanna Crossland. Daniel Charles Cross. Heather Mary Jean Cross. Senior Scholar in Arts, Rose Tara Crozier. Sally Marie Curtis. Stephen Darrell Curtis. Patricia Danielle Salas Dakanai. Natalia Damjanovic. Paula Moto Juris David. Courtney Francis Davis. Kavindri Kini Saranguhewa, De Silva. Demet Demden. James Kim Devereaux. Shaolin Renee Dick. Cairns Robert Dixon Cudd. Christina Natalie Dow. Astra Elizabeth Druker Michaels. Hao Yang Du. Duan Zifeng. Anna Jane Dekroff. Melissa Madison Easterbrook. Elizabeth Lani Ene Tohulale. Lauren Jane Esner. Coriana May Eramija. Maxine Lisa Erasmus. Jordan Esikia. Thomas Charles Everett. Anna Elizabeth Faber. Suzanne Lucy Farmer. Zoe Janet Fenton. Jessica Amy Field. Gardinia Ivadni Misa Fifita. Soli Marie Finboya daughter. Heather Elizabeth Fish. Genevieve Shigwin Fitzjames. Talia Amber Fong. Ailish Marie Ford. Moraika Fouché. Matt John Fowler. Lauren Marjorie Footer and a diploma in languages. Pro-Chancellor, I now call upon the Deputy Dean of the Faculty of Arts, Professor Luciano, to present further graduates.
To the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Caitlin Rose Gabriel. Lucy Jane Gardine. Kelly Ann Gascogne. Douglas John Gaylord. Danielle Elizabeth Garrity. Amberly Kate Gibson. Charlotte May Buchanan Gibson. Elizabeth Rose Giles. Lalena Victoria Giles. Holly Laura Gillies. Claire Louise Goldsberry. Jack. Brendan Robert Grant. Holly Ann Keeley Griffin. Chloe Redemoana Grimmer. Jindong Guo. Charlotte Elizabeth Guy. Harriet Elizabeth Constance Guy. Patrick Rory Halpin Witt. Emily Robin Milne Hames. Faitalia Palapoa Andrew Blay Hamilton Palmer. Joanne K. Hanover. Rebecca Malone Hardy. Oliver Darcy Harper. Michaela Isabel Harris. Erin Louise Hatch. Rebecca Lauren Hawes. Charlotte Hawkins. Melinda Daphne Hayes. Amelia Jane Frances Heaven. Brittany June Hefford. Natalie Rose Henderson Riley. Melissa Hungi Jin. Yeri Ho. Sarah Elizabeth Herbert. Elise Michelle Hill. Kane Julius Hind. Ebony Hodder. Laura Frances Ellen Hodgson. Emily Rose Holden. Yuyin Hong. Brooke Tina Maria Horan. Bailey Marie Hughes. Abby Humphreys. Woo! Shannon Rose Hunter. Shafunaz Charlotte Farisha Hussein. Haley Louise Hutsby. Bianca Jo Hutton. Jihi Wang. Abigail Anna Highland. Aida Ibrahim Begoff. Senior Scholar in Arts, Melissa Ann Irvin. Martina Isho. Tarane Jafari. Kathleen Marie James. Rebecca Marie Jameson. Narate Benicia Jeffries. Unming Jong. Benjamin Daniel Jessup. Johnny Jang. Vivienne Louise Joe. Vicky Tetaratoko John. Madeline Grace Johnson. Ethan John Jones. Jordan Luke Jones. Jaewoo Jung. Jessica Jisoo Jung. Jessica Lynn Kadarmia. Hannah Marena Tatiana Kahe Tairiri. Samora Cake. Camilla Loretta Kassler. Samantha Julianne Keane. Connor Sean Walter Keenan. Senior Scholar in Arts, Rosaria Byrne Kelly. Charles Connolly Kemp. Marie Alice Kent. Rabia Ruhi Khan. Byung-so Kim. Francis Kim. Jihi Kim. Haley Kim. Kim Hong Jae. Jung Hyun Kim. Kim. Soo-yeon Kim. Vanessa Laura Kin. Veronica Viola Kirisame. Tess Natalie Kirkham. Stephanie Rose Kitchen. Savannah Jo Wilhelmina Klein. Jenny Karen Knight. Apurva Lakshmi Koluro. Anika Lisbeth Kral. Agnieszka Kubica. Rikangjali Kumar. Shamintha Neera Kumar. Jessica Jean Miriam Langley. Sina Loimata Latu. Senior Scholar in Arts, Carmen Lau. Connor Brendan Loveridge Lavery. Josiah Andrew Laurie. Langi Tanya Leapai. Joel Derek Lever. Abby Lee. Dongkyun Lee. Genevieve Ann Lee. Haywan Lee. Jonathan G. Whaley. Yi Whaley. Loretta Grace Leha. Rihanna Patricia Lennox. Galun Leung. Jia Yi Lee. Mengyu Lee. Wailan Yi. Andrew Poyu Lin. Amy Asenate Lole Taylor. Anna Patricia Hechanova Liu. Liu Hong Shun. Rachel Ji Ying Liu. Stephen Yi Chuang Liu. Yao Liu. Edward Shohei Lunt. Chelsea Grace McDonald. Emma Rose McGee. Hikuleo Thea Omeako Melaya Mahini. Brittany Louise Mayor. Shane Adam Malva. Rahul Rajan Maniam. Nicole Jane Murray. Ziba Shamsi Marandi Leme. Georgia Claire Martin. Georgia Louise Martin. Hannah Olivia Martin. Aaron Jeffrey Presto Masagne. Nathan Daniel Maskell. Sonia Emma Masco. Josephine Henrika Tenhave Masson. Tasanya Gladys Mataupu. Stephen John Mathiason. Tessa Charlotte Maisie Richardson. Emma Louise McCall. Shannon Beverly Francis McDonald. Morgan Louise McGregor. Miriam Jean Moira MacGyver. Ruth Elizabeth McKenna. Dylan Russell McKnight. Brent Anthony Meadows. Jasmine Asenate Melesea. Melissa Priti Menon. Michelle Elizabeth Louise Mayuli. Haley Bridget Meyer. Rui Miao. Kirsty Joanna Michelle.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Brigitte Balsart on violin will now perform Obsession by Eugene Ysaÿe. Thank you, Brigitta, for that wonderful performance. Ladies and gentlemen, please join with me again in thanking Brigitta. If you would like to hear more from our wonderful young musicians, I invite you to attend the graduation concerto gala competition to be held in the Town Hall on Thursday, 12 May at 7:30 p.m. Admission is free. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Education and Social Work, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I now call upon the head of the School of Humanities, Associate Professor Campbell, to present further graduands in the faculty.
The degree of Bachelor of Arts, Saskia Nicole Miller. Melissa Claire Miller. Nicola Louise Milne. Pallavi Priyeshna Mishra. James Peter Mitchell. Benjamin David Morgan. Janice Cherie Morris. Leah Constance Rose Morris. Brittany Grace Mullacrane Munson. Mamaroa Heath Munn. Rebecca Joy Murphy. To the degree of Bachelor of Theology, Michelle Claire Bull. Alexander Bruce Tipping Smith. Kesaya Tapu-Eluelu. Emmanuel Prakash Baladam. Roseanne Elizabeth Wills. To the degree of Bachelor of Arts Conjoint, Jeffrey Beinart Smolin and a Bachelor of Laws. Andrea Ching Chung and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alexandra Mead Cliff and a Bachelor of Commerce. Senior Scholar in Arts Robert Edward Drummond and a Bachelor of Science. Tanya Emma Fonseca and a Bachelor of Music. Kieran Mark Gainsford and a Bachelor of Science. Frederick Harold Gillies and a Bachelor of Commerce. Xiaoying Gong and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Danielle Jane Hawkins and a Bachelor of Science. Cody Patrick Hedder and a Bachelor of Science. Samuel Jaffe and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sarah Pearl Emily Laycock and a Bachelor of Commerce. Anastasia Leskova and a Bachelor of Fine Arts Honours with Second Class Honours Second Division. Louisa Lin Liu, and a Bachelor of Science. Zachary William Fatu Lo Lan Ting, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Victoria Jacqueline McCulloch, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Ashley May Martin, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Mitchell James Mentor, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Oliver Baxter Mills, and a Bachelor of Science. Caitlin Ariane Phillips, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Bronwyn Rebecca Presland, and a Bachelor of Science. Ibnin Kazi, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Hannah Laura Spencer, and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Senior Scholar in Arts and Senior Scholar in Business and Economics, Daniel Philip Van Vorselen, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Samuel Alan Viskovich, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alexander James Walsh, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Ashley D. Williams, and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Brendan Michael Wong, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sergi Wu, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Kana Yamasaki, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Postgraduate Diploma in Translation Studies with Distinction. Michelle Robin Edwards. Rianne Wen Susan Roberta Horn. Lai Xiao Zhong. Nadia Nell. Jen Jen Wong. Postgraduate Diploma in Translation Studies with Merit. Mei Wen Fan. Chilert Jin. Adele Joan Masters. Postgraduate Diploma in Translation Studies, Sarah Durich. To the degree of Bachelor of Arts Honours with First Class Honours. Azariah Alarca Quintana Alfonte in Spanish. Tessa Samantha Baines in Criminology. Mary Grace Balmas in Employment Relations and Organisation Studies. Samantha Joan Barnes in Psychology and a Bachelor of Arts. Faculty Graduate Scholar Rachel Ann Berryman in Media, Film and Television. Laura Marie Conroy in Ancient History. Maria Therese Corkin in Psychology. Nicola Mary Corner in Criminology. Michaela Ann Curtis in English. Sophie Iris Helen David in History and a Bachelor of Arts. University Graduate Scholar Andrew Francis Xavier Dawson in English. Julian Marihi de Bruin in Politics and International Relations and a Bachelor of Arts. Jessica Marjorie Douglas in Art History and a Bachelor of Arts Conjoint and a Bachelor of Commerce. Ashley Jean Favell in Ancient History. Lauren Elizabeth Anne Fowell in French. Sarah Louise Ferguson in Anthropology. Anoush Jessica Franklin in Psychology. Faculty Graduate Scholar Natalie Sarah Jaman in Psychology. Madeline Violet Gifford in Art History. Lillian Charlotte Hanley in Media, Film and Television. Danielle Joy Hay in Psychology. Jordan Alex Houston in Ancient History. Elise Anita Lockhead Huggard in Ancient History. Lucy Irwin in History. Lloyd Vincent Johns in Anthropology. Tureen Huiro Jones in Drama. Pauline Barbara Kajetanowicz in French. Rowan James Clevstall in Art History. Graham Robert Lees in French. Amanda Grace Su-Shen Liu in Drama and a Bachelor of Arts. University Graduate Scholar Robert Peter Loretz in Philosophy. Gemma Ann Mansell in Art History and a Bachelor of Arts. Andrew Robert McIndoe in History. Alexandra Jane McIntyre in History and a Bachelor of Arts. Charlotte Rachel Thea Moss in Development Studies. Stefan Nikolic in Philosophy. Alison Rachel Officer in Geography. Su Jin Park in Spanish. Emily Louise Kelly Robertson in Politics and International Relations. University Graduate Scholar Thomas Duncan Robertson in Mathematics. Eden Shana Rogers in Ancient History. Fiona Suzanne Bryson Ryan in History. Anya Domino Maria Samara Singh in Art History. Kieran David Vivahu Sinclair in History. Mariana Stetsiv in Politics and International Relations. University Graduate Scholar Declan Alexander Liddington Thompson in Logic and Computation. Faculty Graduate Scholar Tycho Rose Vandenberg in Psychology. Corinne Angela Watson in Art History. Courtney Joan Wentz in Art History. Emily Rose Whelan in Psychology. Senior Scholar in Arts and University Graduate Scholar Samuel James White in Mathematics and a Bachelor of Arts. Emily Louise Whitehead in Ancient History. Jed Taylor Wilkins in Psychology and a Bachelor of Arts. University Graduate Scholar Prudence Sophie Mary Wilson in Sociology. Emma Grace Ray in Art History. Could Senior Scholar in Arts and Faculty Graduate Scholar Jul Chung Jin in Screen Production and a Bachelor of Arts and a Diploma in Languages. To the degree of Bachelor of Arts Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, Marco Zonio Argievsky in English and a Bachelor of Arts. Georgia Kazinas Casey in Art History. Michael Rutherford Chapman in Geography. Michael Grant Clark in Media, Film and Television. Sayan Savaro Cotinho in Media, Film and Television. Oliver Ambrose Cull in Geography and a Bachelor of Arts. Sophia Charlotte Dawson in Psychology. Annette Frances Docking in English. Gordon Stewart Lowndes Elder in History. Kirsty Jane Hamilton in Screen Production. Daniel Waru Heki in Ancient History. Zoe Catherine Lavatangaloa Henry in History. Vari Catherine Lennox in Screen Production. Amy Lin in Media, Film and Television and a Bachelor of Arts. Ashley Ruth Littlewood in Art History. Tommy Sokun Long in Politics and International Relations. Rachel Jocelyn Longshore Park in Drama. Sophie Mianmi McEwen in Media, Film and Television and a Bachelor of Arts. Sarah Ann McLean in Criminology. James David Murray in Employment Relations and Organisation Studies. Milika Sela Agapi Pomana in Anthropology. Sonia D. Wheeler Pope in Education. Georgia Margaret Kirk Looping in English. Jet Hartley Cruz Sharp in Sociology. Daniel George Smith in Criminology. Lee Thompson in Psychology. Sophie Jane Taylor Woolwich in History and a Bachelor of Arts. To the degree of Bachelor of Arts Honours with Second Class Honours Second Division, Shail Kalshal in Politics and International Relations. Amrisha Sumaran in Politics and International Relations. Maria Adriana Wheeler in History. To the degree of Bachelor of Theology Honours with First Class Honours, Therese Kiley. To the degree of Master of Arts with First Class Honours, Alexandra Susan Bonham in Drama. Vanessa Day Cole in Sociology. University Graduate Scholar Hilary Dancy Dutton in Education. Eloise Joy Hoffman in Anthropology. Natalie June Jacques in Sociology. Beda Abdul Kadim Jarala Jaba in Politics and International Relations. Yali Liu in Applied Linguistics. George Oliver Mason in Translation Studies and a Bachelor of Arts and a Postgraduate Diploma in Translation Studies with distinction. Joseph Daniel Mills in Anthropology. University Graduate Scholar Finn William Morrow in Sociology. Neti Singh Nanda in Psychology and a Postgraduate Diploma in Art with Merit in Psychology. Neha Patel in Ancient History. Vari Nicole Penman in Ancient History. Angela Belinda Rapson in Sociology. Simon Edward Underwood in Ancient History. Yasmin Rachel Strauger Wally in Geography. Hannah Christine Wilson in Politics and International Relations. Stephanie Marie Wilson in Development Studies. To the degree of Master of Arts with Second Class Honours, First Division, Inga Farouk Abdulbaki in Applied Linguistics. Yuko Araki in Applied Linguistics. Sarah Marguerite Jacobs in Museums and Cultural Heritage. Di Liang in Translation Studies. Dennis John Makasak in Development Studies. Taylor Amy Jane Pitt in Drama. Shreta Mayuri Ryan in English. Jung Sun in Translation Studies. Maxwell Alexander Presto Tarrant in Politics and International Relations. Benedict Isaiah Alves Hui in Politics, in Media, Film and Television. Chen Wang in Applied Linguistics. Yuan Shu in Applied Linguistics. To the degree of Master of Arts with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Jing Wen Annette Chu in Politics and International Relations. An Zhou Zhou in Translation Studies. Amanda Xiao Ern Teo in Art History and a Bachelor of Arts Honours with Second Class Honours First Division in Art History and a Bachelor of Arts. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with First Class Honours, Sky Mandrake Stewart Menteith in International Relations and Human Rights. The degree of Master of Professional Studies with Second Class Honours First Division, Jung Jun He in International Relations and Human Rights. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with Second Class Honours Second Division, Hamid Moradi in Language Teaching. To the degree of Master of Literature, Gabriel Mahesh Prasad Sharma in Theology. Bachelor of Arts Honours, Second Class Honours, First Division, Catherine Isabel Hartgill-Rees in Education.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Phyllis K. Anscombe in Political Studies. Phyllis examined how government-funded charities that provide social services have input to government policy. From a data set of 200 charities, 23 case studies revealed that policy advocacy strategies are clearly influenced by government funding, but their advocacy responds to the needs of service users and communities. Ian Anthony Cook in Art History, University Doctoral Scholar. Ian examined the acceleration in art-related interactions that occurred between New Zealand and the United States in the period from 1955 to 1974. He looked at a selection of the most important of these encounters, exploring their impacts and implications, and showed how they informed and were informed by broader artistic, political, and institutional contexts. Ian. Courtney Elizabeth Harper in History, University Doctoral Scholar. Courtney investigated the emergence of diabetes as an important public health concern in post-World War II New Zealand and the responses to this issue. Researching the responses of health professionals, policymakers, the public, and the patients themselves, she showed how diabetes history contributes to an understanding of public health history more broadly, as well as to state and voluntary welfare history. Jeremy Richard Johnson in Philosophy. Jeremy evaluated philosophical claims about the relationships between morality, reason, and motivation. Using insights from Wittgenstein and Heidegger, he argued that some claims are clearly true in one sense and false in another, whereas other claims cannot be shown to be true or false by either empirical research or philosophical analysis. Jeremy. Ray Tsai Kong in Asian Studies. The study investigated heterogeneity in the representation of the theme of revolution and the model performances within the aesthetic framework of socialist realism. Through a rigorous critique of socialist realism, the study offers an aesthetic approach to the socialist culture of the Maoist era. Right, so. Lee Wan Fei in Politics and International Relations. Wan Fei examined elements of justice and peace in classical Chinese canons in light of comparative study in international political and legal theory. His critical investigation lays the cornerstone for constructive dialogues between ancient China and the contemporary West on global governance and on the use of force for humanitarian purposes, resulting in a more comprehensive and sustainable solution for mass atrocities. One fine. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Arts.
Teaching Excellence Awards. The university places considerable significance on excellence in teaching. It recognises this by making awards each year to teachers who have demonstrated excellence in aspects of teaching. These awards are contestable across the university and signify a truly superior achievement. An award for sustained excellence in teaching has been made to Dr. Eduardo Pinero in the Department of European Languages and Literature within the Faculty of Arts. I call upon a student of that faculty, Dong Mei Lin, to read the citation for Dr. Pinero.
When I was first asked to read the citation for Dr. Eduardo Pinero's, I hesitated because of a lack of confidence in public English speaking. But I soon realized that I should grab this opportunity to convey my appreciation for all that he has done for students like me who are interested in Spanish. Eduardo has been my teacher and mentor for almost 5 years. From all my experiences studying and working with him, I'm completely convinced that he possesses a pedagogical talent. As a teacher, his work in the classroom is truly excellent. His ability to engage students is especially remarkable. The entire class feels his energy and enthusiasm as he walks us through the arguments of analysis. He's also a powerful communicator who has the gift of making complex linguistic constructs easy to understand. After each class, he makes every student feel proud of their newly acquired knowledge and make the study of Spanish linguistics a rewarding experience. Eduardo's talent in teaching is also reflected in other directions, such as undergraduate course coordination and postgraduate supervision. As a course coordinator, Eduardo observes each JTA's class and gives constructive suggestions which assist them to adjust their teaching strategies for language learners of different levels and to create a more communicative and student-centered learning environment. As a postgraduate supervisor and a mentor, he never imposes, but rather inspires and guides students to find their own passion and gradually become effective researchers. Dr. Eduardo Pinero's excels at transmitting his knowledge in a positive environment, and his commitment to his profession is beyond compare. He's eminently deserving of the Sustained Excellence in Teaching Award.
We are now nearing the end of this graduation ceremony. On behalf of the university, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. while you are standing, this will be a great opportunity for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieved their qualifications. Thank you. This concludes this meeting of council and convocation of the university for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you all to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of the programme.